the Bunsen Burner. In this video, you will learn what a Bunsen Burner is and how to use a Bunsen Burner. Why is it called a Bunsen Burner anyway? Well, see that dude that just popped on the screen? Yeah, that one. That's Robert Bunsen. He's a German chemist who invented this apparatus. Bunsen burners are used in a science lab to heat things up. When working in a lab, it is very important to know the proper terms for each apparatus and their parts. If not, it would be very difficult to give proper instructions. For example, what would you do if your teacher told you to,
little boy, can you connect the long thingy to the yellow thingy on top of the gray thingy, please?
Huh? So here are the names of the parts of the Bunsen burner. First is the chimney or the barrel. It is the tube where air passes through. This is the air hole. It is the hole which allows the air in the surrounding area to enter the chimney. I'll let you in on a little secret. You need air to make fire. Mm-hmm. This is the sliding collar. It slides around the area, allowing you to control how much air enters into the chimney or barrel. This is the base which keeps the Bunsen burner steady. We don't want a lit Bunsen burner toppling over, do we? Okay, this is the gas inlet which allows fuel, in this case, methane gas, to enter the chimney. I'll let you in on another secret. You also need fuel to make fire. This is the rubber tubing. Its job is to connect the gas inlet to the gas tap. The gas tap regulates or controls the amount of fuel that goes through the Bunsen burner. So, just how do we use a Bunsen burner? First, we connect the gas inlet to the gas tap by using the rubber tubing. Second, make sure the air hole is closed. You can do this by rotating the sliding collar until the air hole is completely covered. Third, light a wooden splint and hold it over the chimney. Then, turn on the gas tap. Do not reverse the order. If you do, there might be a big kaboom accident in the lab, and we don't want that to happen. Oh, and by the way, I'll let you in on another secret. The last thing you need to make fire is a heat source. Shh, we don't want a lot of people to know about that. Why are we showing you how to use the Bunsen burner this way? Why don't we watch an amazing instructional video starring one of your teachers and lab technicians? Ready? Let's do it! If you look around the science labs, you will see that all the cupboards are labeled. This makes it easy for you to find what you need. When you get to the lab, look around and be familiar with the different apparatus. If you will be using the Bunsen burner for a lab practical, you will need the following apparatus. Safety goggles, lighter, wooden splint, heat-proof mat. Don't worry, that's not blood, just melted red-orange crayon. Wire gauze, tripod stand, the Bunsen burner, and the gas tap. This is how you set up. Put the tripod stand on the heat-proof mat. Position the Bunsen burner under the tripod stand. Connect the rubber tubing to the gas tap. Make sure the connection is secure. We don't want methane gas escaping into the lab atmosphere. That's another reason for a kaboom lab accident. Put the wire gauze on top of the tripod stand. Take a match and wooden splint and then... Wait! What's wrong, you say? Miss, you have long hair. You know that if you have long hair, you must tie it back. We don't want hair accidentally burning in the lab. That's a kaboom accident. Also, you need to wear your safety goggles. Yes, even if you are wearing glasses already. You see, your glasses don't protect the sides of your eyes. Safety goggles do. Good job. Now, we're ready. Usually, you will be working with a partner. So make sure you and your partner have safety goggles and hair tied back if needed. Now, let's light up the Bunsen burner. Before lighting up the Bunsen burner, position the apparatus on the wire gauze. In this case, we are using a beaker with some water. Ready? Stop! You always have to make sure that the air hole is closed. Use the sliding collar. Also, make sure the rubber tubing is away from the tripod stand legs. Now, like the splint. Position it on top of the chimney and then turn on the gas tap. Remember, do not reverse the order or else, kaboom! To extinguish the flame, rub the splint on the heatproof mat. Do not blow the flame. Stop! Also, put the extinguished splint on the heatproof mat, not on the bench, which is actually the table, just so we know. Now, let's put a thermometer into the beaker. Stop! If you examine the beaker, you will see it has a groove. Position the thermometer there. Now your experiment is in progress. Good job! Stop! When an experiment is in progress, you must monitor or closely look at your experiment. Not chit-chat, exchange jokes, or give each other high fives. First of all, you need to record your results. And second, you need to make sure of your setup safety. After all, you are using a Bunsen burner. If you lit up the Bunsen burner correctly, meaning you made sure that the air hole was completely closed, then you can safely touch the sliding collar to open the air hole. Good job, ladies! Yay! Now, the experiment is over. How do you clean up? First, close the air hole and then turn off the gas tap. Second, remove the thermometer and put it... Stop! Not on the bench, on the heatproof mat. Remember, it's hot. Next, stop! Didn't I just say it's hot? Ayah! Wait 5 to 10 minutes for it to cool down. While waiting, you may return the non-hot apparatus such as the safety goggles, lighter, and splint. Important note, if the bell is about to ring, just leave the Bunsen burner set up. The lab techs will take care of it. Remove the beaker and empty the contents into the sink. Make sure you do it close to the sink so that the water won't splash all over. Remove the rubber tubing from the gas tap. Pull out the Bunsen burner, remove the wire gauze, and invert the tripod onto the heatproof mat. Return all those apparatus to their proper places. Put used apparatus, those that need to be washed or dried, such as the beaker and thermometer, into the used apparatus bin. And there you have it. Easy peasy lemon squeezy, right? By the way, you will be using this setup for one of your lab practicals. Excited? I am. Woohoo!